for today is 10 critical decisions taken by operations manager. Okay, so as I have told earlier about what is production, what is operations, and what are the roles and responsibilities of operations manager. So these are some of the important decisions that generally operations management take. Okay, like first is service or product design. Okay, means what is the product of a company, what is what would be the product line of a company, what would be the services that you offer along with the product, or you are either offering only product or you are offering a combination of both product as well as services. Okay, that you need to decide. Okay, means what type of services and what type of product you are going to design for your customer, you are going to facilitate facilitate to your customer basically. Okay, so that is a critical decision that our operations manager should take, okay, or should taken into consideration. Okay, that what would be the product design and what are the customers asking for. Means generally, if you see that earlier cell phones were of having very bulky design, but nowadays a lot many sleek designs are available of cell phones. Okay, and continuously there is a change there. You may notice a change regarding in terms of design perspective of a product. Okay, design perspective of cell phone generally. So if you talk about car, automobile, okay, so recently you see that facelift model of every car is being launched nowadays, okay, just because of its demand basically. Okay, so what is product design, what is product, what is your product line, and what type of design customers are asking. Okay, what type of services customers are opting for, like nowadays for automobile security is of utmost concern, so you should provide a crash test report basically. Okay, ki how much or up to what extent you are providing a safe product to your customer basically. Okay, nowadays customers are asking for organic product or eco friendly product or green products basically. Okay, so you need to decide whether which type of product you are going to offer to your customers basically. Okay, so that is a important decision, that is a critical decision that a operation manager must take. Okay, next is quality management. What is quality management basically? First you should need to understand this quality first. Okay, so what is quality basically? Quality is consumer's perception about the product, means how you perceive about a product. Okay, like for example, if you want to assess the quality of a product, okay, so for assessing quality of a product you need to consume it. Okay, and after that you may make a comparative analysis to test whether which product is having better quality in comparison to the other product. Okay, so that is quality basically. Quality is what consumer's perception about the product, means how you are perceiving about a product. Okay, similarly in case of services, okay, you are quality management or quality evaluation is somehow difficult in terms of services in comparison to product. Okay, because for a failing service you need to choose a different service provider. Okay, and for that you need to wait in some extent. Okay, so that's why quality management means what quality parameters customers are considering in your product, or what type of quality parameters customers are looking for. Like for example, nowadays most of the consumers are looking towards a car that are having better mileage. Okay, so for that they are having only one option, that is Maruti, because Maruti car is much more economical in terms of mileage than other competitors. Okay, so means in a certain segment, what is the customer's utmost importance? Okay, in terms of safety, Tata is better in Indian market, but in terms of mileage, if you talk about, in terms of serviceability, if you talk about, Maruti is better. So what is quality? Quality is basically parameters that customers define. Okay, that customers perception, based on customers perception, and operations manager must decide that what customer is asking for which type of product. Like I am giving you here an example. Okay, nowadays it is a summer means nowadays hot weather is there and you are asking for AC. Okay, so if you go for Gree, okay, Gree is a brand that is means that is providing an AC, and they are claiming that they are providing AC operating voltage 300 volt. Okay, so maybe means that is based on their ideal condition, but they are means they are putting it as a quality parameter. Means if you are eco-friendly and if you want to save your money in terms of electricity, then you should opt for Gree company. Okay, so that is basically his USP, that company's USP basically. Okay, so that is quality. Means what is your USP? Okay, what is your key catch point for which you are selling basically? Okay, so that is quality management, and that is utmost important decision, and that should be taken by operations manager. Means in which segment you are taking care of your product basically, and what are your target customer and what are you selling basically, what parameters you are selling basically. Okay, like Lufthansa Airlines, okay, you have seen ad, okay, they are selling luxurious, okay, luxury in terms of traveling basically. Okay, so what is that basically? Quality management, to manage the quality, to manage the need of customer, to map the need of customer and to provide the better product or better services to meet those quality parameters of your customers or consumers basically. Okay, so that is another important decision that that an operation manager must consider. Third is process or capacity design. What is process or capacity design? Process is different thing, capacity is different thing. Process is what, by which way you are going to manufacture your product. Okay, means by which way you are going to manufacture or you may going to convert your raw material into desired output, okay, or desired service basically. So that is process. So in processes there are various sub processes, and sub processes are composed of various sub activities or activities basically. So you need to design all those activity, you need to design all those sub processes, you need to design all those map all those activities or sub processes to streamline your process basically, to see that the process flow is in better way. Okay, process sequence is better, process interdependence is better. So that you need to decide. Similarly, you need to decide upon the capacity. Capacity in line with your demand basically. Okay, what is the demand of your consumer, and you need to decide capacity in terms of your demand. Okay, if you are having unlimited demand, then you need to decide a capacity that you may provide. Okay, so in that case you are having limited capacity, like you can't open a restaurant to feed entire world basically. Okay, so for that you need to decide a limited capacity restaurant to operate. Okay, but in case if you are providing a software and that only you are providing across the globe, for that you need to design your capacity up to certain extent that you can take in care the demand of entire globe. Okay, so basically capacity design, capacity should be in line with your demand basically, ki how much demand your product is having, and in line with that demand you need to design your capacity. Okay, next important consideration that an operations manager must consider is location. Okay, what is location? Location is very crucial and very critical decision that you need to consider, because a competitive location may give a lot to you basically in terms of strategic advantage are there, in terms of competitive advantage are there, in terms of business environment, in terms of other factors are there. So in terms of location, like location, there are multiple factors on which location depends, like availability of raw material, availability of labor, availability of resources, technology, process availability, okay, and whether your process is labor intensive, whether your process is capital intensive, whether which type of competitive advantage you are going to take, okay, what is your USP, what is your product line. So all these things comes under the category of locations basically. So while deciding location, you need to consider a lot many factors to decide location. Okay, like I have given you an example that you can't open a IT company in Dasna, okay, just because it will not give you a locational advantage. If you want to operate or if you want to open an IT company, then you need to select either Bangalore or Hyderabad. That would be a better location for your that IT company basically. Okay, so what is this basically for location perspective? It is also a critical decision that an operation manager must consider. Okay, next is layout design. What is layout design basically? Layout is what? Arrangement of available space, okay, in terms of facilitating smooth flow of material, human resource, as well as communication. Okay, so layout is what generally you see when you enter in a plant. You see that a layout is mentioned over there regarding the facility. Okay, so what is that basically? To design a layout means where the production plant is there, where the office space are there, where the business lounge is there, where auditorium is there, where green land is there. So all these things you need to design over there so that any layman person can see that layout and can understand that where the main facility is or where he or she needs to go basically. Okay, and similarly there are different type of layout structures are there. Like if you see call center operations, so you may see different type of layout. In case of banking, you may see different type of layout. In case of offices, there are different types of layout. Okay, in terms of educational institution, different types of layouts are there. Okay, so that is also an important decision to take in care of layout design. Okay, similarly you may see that in case of malls, okay, where you are frequently going to buy something, okay, you see that high frequency items are located in ground floor basically, okay, to generally promote the footprint, okay, to promote the footprint of customers basically. And low frequency items like PVR and some furniture, etc., positioned in top floor basically. So what is that basically? A part of layout design. Okay, so that is also an important decision that an operation manager must consider. Okay, next is human resource job design. Okay, what is human resource? Human resource is an important asset that your organization must consider. And in case of operations manager, how human resources is important? Basically, operations manager deals with those human resources. They may be skilled, they may be unskilled, and they may be semi-skilled. So using those human resource, operations manager must take decision that how to better utilize those human resources in your plant. Okay, so basically operation manager must decide the job design, whether it is a specialized one or it is empowered one. What is specialized basically? A specialized job is like if you are operating in lathe machine or CNC machine, or if you are operating CAD or CAM. So for that you need a specialized person. Okay, and in case of if you are working certain project, so in that case you need to have some empowered people, okay, that are willingness to work in different scenario. Okay, generally manager's job is to work in empowered setting basically. Okay, that's why you are going to equip with different type of specialization. like you are generally going through marketing, you are going through finance, you are going to HR, OB, IT, operations, etc. Okay, just because in future you may get those enriched or empowered assignment basically. Okay, you need to deal with each and every aspects of management. So for that, you are going to equipped with all such specialization basically. Okay, so that an operation management must consider that how productively he or she can deploy the or utilize the skills of their human resource in production plant in facility basically. So for that he need to take a decision basically, okay, that where to deploy which person. So this is an important decision that an operation manager must take. Next is supply chain management. As I have told earlier, that supply chain is a chain between end supplier to end customer. Okay, what is end supplier? End supplier is supplier, then manufacturer, then distributor, then retailer, and then customers, and customer may be there. Okay, so that is supply chain. So basically supply chain would be optimum one if there are certain or limited number of linkage over there. But nowadays since we are working generally in assembled type of setting, so in that case means you need to manage a lengthy supply chain. Like in case of Amul Mother Dairy, they are taking milk from lot many farmers. Okay, after that they are chilling it and they are sending it to the processing plant, and after that package it and sell it to the customer. So entire supply chain, to manage entire supply chain, a lot many skills, a lot many resources are required basically to manage all such a supply chain basically. So it is also an important decision taken by the operation manager. Okay, supply chain efficiency should also consider, supply chain integration should also consider, supply chain coordination should also consider, supply chain performance should also consider, design should also consider, and many more decisions are there related with the supply chain, because supply chain is very vast vast domain in today's scenario basically. So operations manager must consider this to manage the supply chain basically, so that he or she can effectively use the supply chain of his or her organization basically. Okay, as I'm giving you example of Dell. So Dell is basically managing its supply chain, and they can sell assembled product, and as per customized assembled product as per the consumer's demand, and within 7 days. Okay, so that is their supply chain excellence basically. Okay, next is inventory management. What is inventory basically? Inventory is stock. Okay, and that is stored in warehouse. So inventory management is what to manage, means how much inventory you need to consider, how much inventory you should keep on hand, how to order, how much to order, when to order, that all these points should taken into consideration while managing the inventory. Okay, so that is also a critical decision that an operation manager must consider. Okay, next is scheduling. What is scheduling basically? Means how much unit will be prepared by whom. Okay, maybe their finite scheduling, maybe their infinite scheduling, that depends totally. But nowadays finite scheduling is there, means start time would be there, end time would be there, and all the resources would be allocated based upon that specified time and by using the Gantt chart. So that is basically scheduling. So nowadays a critical assignment is or critical decision is that is taken by operation manager is to schedule that production. Okay, like if you want to produce a transformer, and generally manufacturing of transformer takes 6 months to 8 months to 1 year. Okay, and for that you need to schedule that on which date what would be performed basically, what work would be performed over there. Okay, so that is basically scheduling. Okay, So finite scheduling is there nowadays, and finite scheduling we if you see that there are resource allocation is there, time allocation is there, okay, and what would be the work, what would be the job roles, responsibility, all the things would be taken care by operations manager to streamline the scheduling and to ensure the output on time basically. Okay, next is maintenance. What is maintenance basically? This is another important decision. What is maintenance? If maintenance generally to maintain something, to manage something, okay, to manage that product basically. So sometimes companies are adopting that repair. So repair leads cost. Okay, why? Because reverse logistics, you will take back that product and after that repair it and will return it to the customer. Okay, so that will lead to a heavy cost basically. Okay, so for that you need to adopt here preventive maintenance. What is preventive maintenance? To prevent all such type of defects, and you are assuring that no defect is occurring in your facility basically. So nowadays we are using Six Sigma, we are using TQM, total quality management, to maintain it. Okay, to in terms of to maintain the preventive maintenance, to use the preventive maintenance. So these are some of the important decisions that our operations manager must take nowadays.